Sarabeth, and today I'm going to be reading Rufus Comes Home, which is a book I got in the hospital when I was diagnosed. Ryan felt very sick. For quite a few weeks, he felt very weak. Tired, thirsty, and seemed to go to the bathroom all the time. Ryan did not feel like himself at all. Ryan's family took him to the doctor to try and find out why he felt so sick. His doctor told his family that she thought Ryan might have a condition called diabetes. She sent them all to the hospital right away. Ryan's family doctor had been right. Soon after he got to the hospital, special diabetes doctors and nurses checked his blood sugar, glucose, with the AccuCheck compact system. Ryan pricked his finger. The nurse helped him touch a drop of his blood to the test sensor, and the test sensor drew the blood away from Ryan's finger, and they waited for the meter to beep. They also took some blood from his arm and sent it to a laboratory for tests. Sure enough, Ryan had too much sugar in his blood. Ryan learned that living with diabetes meant his body could not turn the extra sugar in his blood into the energy that his body needed. This is why Ryan felt so sick and tired all the time during the last few weeks. Ryan discovered that when his diabetes was not in good control, like when he got to the hospital, he felt really sick. His body made him go to the bathroom a lot because it was trying to get rid of all the extra sugar it had in it. People without diabetes have something their bodies make called insulin that takes care of all that kinds of stuff. Insulin is a hormone that is made by cells in the part of the body called the pancreas. The pancreas is near the stomach. Having diabetes meant that Brian's pancreas cells did not make enough of the hormone called insulin anymore. Because Brian's body didn't make enough insulin, he and his family had to learn a lot about having diabetes would mean for their lives. For example, to take place of the insulin Brian's body no longer made, he learned that he would have to take insulin in shots every day. Usually, Brian would get two more shots each day. At first, Brian didn't like the idea of getting shots every day. Who would? But after he got the insulin, he felt so much better. Brian and his family learned more and more about diabetes every day. They learned from diabetes teachers in the hospital that it was best if Brian ate his meals and snacks about the same time each day. It was important for his family to have regular schedule each and every day, and when Brian went to school or played sports. Not being on a regular schedule or not eating when he was supposed to could make Brian get sick. He learned about highs, like when he had too much sugar in his blood, and about lows, when he didn't have enough sugar in his blood to balance the insulin from the shots. Lows meant Brian needed to get some sugar and food into his body right away. Brian wished he knew someone with diabetes. He knew he could always talk to his family about his feelings, and of course his doctors and nurses too. Still, as much as they all wanted to help, they didn't have diabetes like Brian did they? Brian longed for someone or something special to share his private diabetes feelings with. After practicing giving shots to oranges in the hospital, Brian's mother kissed him goodbye. She had a few errands to catch up on before Brian's family brought him home from the hospital. Besides, his grandma was with him, and grandma was happy to sit and talk with him until Brian's mother got back to the hospital. It felt good to have grandma there with him. After finishing her errands, Brian's mother quickly stopped by a toy store to find something special to take back to the hospital for Brian. Finally, his mother's bright green eyes spotted the perfect little friend for Brian. A warm, cuddly, stuffed teddy bear sat lonely on the toy shelf waiting for someone to love. Brian's mother knew that bear would be loved a great deal by Brian. Brian's mother dropped off a few things at home, then realized that there were just a few more things to do before she went back to the hospital. Brian's mother remembered that her son had told her earlier that he wished he had someone special or something special to share his private diabetes feelings with. His mother thought the new bear might be the perfect listener for him. Brian's mother gently and lovingly hand-sewn felt patches on different parts of the bear's body in exactly the same spots where Brian now had to get his insulin shots. She carefully cut out little red felt hearts and sewed them to the bear's paws, where Brian now had to do his finger pricks. Next, she added a special medical bracelet for the bear's arm to tell everyone about the bear's special condition so he would be safe. Finally, the finishing touch, a little diabetes t-shirt from the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation that fit just right on the bear. Now the bear with diabetes was perfect, just like Brian. After a few hours, Brian's mother hurried back to the hospital, where she found him and his grandma playing a board game. Now that Brian was getting the insulin his body needed, he was almost back to his good old self. For the first time in a long time, Brian was smiling again. Brian's mother handed Brian a big bag with a red bow on it. Inside was Brian's special new bear. Brian pulled it out and hugged it with all his might. He named the bear Rufus, the bear with diabetes, right away. Brian couldn't wait until he could show his diabetes doctors and nurses his new bear. As soon as he came into his room, he showed them how he could not only test his own blood sugar now, but also Rufus's. Soon it was time for Brian's shot. This time, it wasn't nearly so bad. Brian got his insulin shot first, then Rufus got his shot, too. It was a lot more fun than practicing on an orange. Finally, it was time for Brian and Rufus to go home. As soon as they got to Brian's house, he found a special place for all of Brian's and Rufus's diabetes supplies. Soon, the whole family settled into their new routine. Whatever Brian did, Rufus did, too. Late that night, when everyone was in bed and the house was all dark and quiet, a tiny small voice could be faintly heard coming from Brian's bedroom. Brian's mother could hear her son whispering in his new friend Rufus's ear. Somewhere deep in her heart, she knew that Rufus was the special something that could really understand Brian and his private diabetes thoughts. Reassuring words could be heard echoing late into the night. A small boy and an even smaller bear somehow understood each other. Brian's mother felt peacefully, closed her eyes, and gently fell asleep for the first time in many, many nights. Yes, everything would be all right. The end.